Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be installing an ASR subframe brace and sway bar, also EMUSA lower control arms, and removing the rear ABS sensors on the silver Integra. Hope you guys enjoy. So here's the ASR subframe brace, sway bar, and spherical end links, ESM control arms. And we're going to be putting on the silver Integra. First thing you want to do is remove the wheels on both sides after you jack the car up. That way you can get to the bolts on the control arms that are on the trailing arm. So I'm going to do that real quick. So once you have the wheel off, you're going to remove the 1, 2, 3, 4 for the ABS sensor, the 3 here for the control arm, and the 2 here for the sway bar on each side. So now that both sides are removed, I want to disconnect the rear speed sensors because I'm not going to be using them. I'm eventually going to get rid of ABS, so I'll show you how to disconnect those. To disconnect the rear speed sensors, you'll see two wires here, two wires on this side. I'm going to remove this little metal bracket. Looks like it's one Phillips head and a 10 on each side, and then just disconnect them. Now that you have the metal cover removed, you're just gonna unclip the connector. I use a flathead to push the rubber grommet through, push the connector through, and then go under the car and finish disconnecting it. So underneath the car, a little past the subframe, you'll see the ABS sensor going up here. There's a plastic clip right here holding it. I'm just gonna use some needle nose pliers and pop that out. And then on the trailing arm, there's a few 10 millimeters. There's one here, and there's about 3 of them over here on this side that you want to take out, and then just remove the whole sensor. So now that all this is removed, I'm going to come over here to the sway bar. I'm going to remove these bolts and take the sway bar off, so I'm just left with the subframe, and I'll show you how to put this on the car. Alright, so once you're ready to put on the subframe brace, you have two pieces like this. The side with the angle is going to face towards the inside, and the part with the divot in it is going to go on the bottom hole. It'll sit like this behind the subframe. And you'll have a bolt and a nut that'll go through the bottom one. So I'll show you how to put this on right now. Once you have the subframe brace up in place, you want to take this piece right here. The bottom part is going to slide onto the bolt that you just put in, and you're going to put the nut on the back. So once you have the nut on the back, you want to tighten those up on both sides. Before I start tightening it up, I'm going to take the longer of the two bolts that's left and just place it into here. Make sure the bracket's still lined up. I'm going to do the same on the other side. Once you have your brackets lined up on both sides, tighten up the first bolt that you put in. Using a ratchet wrench will make it a lot easier. Once you have that done, you're ready for the sway bar. So I'm gonna go grab that real quick. So I'm gonna remove the top bolts that I put in to line up the brackets. I'm gonna line up the sway bar with these holes. The shorter bolt's gonna go on the bottom. Install the two top ones, which are the longer bolts. So on this part, if you have the regular OEM lower control arm bolts, you'll put those in now. I have the optional bolts that you can order if you want to use a tie bar. Don't have a tie bar, but I'm going to use this anyway. I'll put the control arm in. So once you have this lined up, you just want to tighten it up. You don't want to torque these down until you have a load on the car. Hope I didn't knock the camera out the way. But you just want to install the bolt on the trailing arm and on the shock. And on the other side, I'm going to put anti-seize on these so they don't break in the future. All right, once you get everything bolted up, you want to take the last bolt. It's going to have two washers on there. The concave side is going to go one on each side of the bearing. And you want to adjust this bearing so it's sitting straight up and down as possible. So I have mine going into the middle hole. Start to thread that in. I'm gonna do the same for the other side and tighten it up. So that's how you want the cone washers to sit once you've tightened up the end links. See how they're pretty straight? That's how you want to have them. Now I'm just gonna throw the wheels back on, lower the car, and tighten the control arm bolts and on the trailing arm. And that's it for this install. Now that everything's tightened up and the car is lowered, fully installed. Hopefully this makes a good handling upgrade. I'll let you guys know in a couple weeks.
Alright guys, that's pretty much going to wrap this video up. I did get a chance to drive the car. It handles much better now. It's a lot more stiffer in the rear. I believe the lower control arms also helped out a lot since the bushings and the stock control arms are pretty much shot. Would recommend this upgrade for anyone who has a stock sway bar setup or just really old bushings. Stay tuned for next episode. I got some more stuff coming up soon. Until next time, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.